Categories and types of pests. Pest is a general term used to describe any organism, usually insects or animals, that is harmful to our health and properties, including crop and livestock. The term in its broader sense also includes microorganisms, parasitic plants, and weeds. Types of pests. Pests are classified into different ways. Classification based on morphological differences. Insect pests, mite pests, microorganisms, pathogens, nematodes, vertebrate pests, molluscs, weeds and parasitic plants. Classification based on nature, intensity or frequency of occurrence. A. Regular pests, a pest that occur every crop season and causes yield losses. B. Sporadic pests, occasional pests. A pest that is irregular, occurs here and there or at random, but occasionally causes problems. C. Potential pests, a pest that could cause significant economic loss if allowed to establish. D. Major pest, a more common and important pest. E. Minor pest, a pest that is not causing huge damage. An insect that multiplies rapidly and builds up a huge population, causing economic losses to crops and other properties, or is a nuisance and health hazard to man and his livestock. Coming to some of the pests, aphids. Pest description and biology. This soft-bodied insect usually lives on new shoots, crowns and undersides of leaves. In general, aphids are slender and dark green to yellow. The aphid life cycle includes egg, nymphs and adults. Adults can be either wingless or winged. Nymphs are similar and similar in shape to adults. Most female aphids reproduce asexually, giving birth to live young that quickly reach maturity and then reproduce. A short life cycle accounts for rapid increases in populations. Under crowded conditions, winged forms develop, disperse and colonize other areas. Aphid nymphs and adults feed by inserting a needle-like structures called stylet into the plant and removing plant sap, thus reducing plant growth. Symptoms of aphid damage include curled, twisted and or stunted leaves, yellowish spots and glossy leaves. Heavy infestations in seedlings or transplants can cause plants to wilt and or die. Black sooty mold due to a fungus may develop on leaves due to the presence of sticky honeydew, which is released by aphids through the cronicles or tube-like structures at the tip of the abdomen. The presence of this mold may reduce photosynthesis, make the plant unattractive and possibly reduce flowering and yields. Some species spread plant viruses. Prevention of aphid vectored viruses is a primary reason for aphid control in vegetables. Spray insecticidal soap, dish washing liquid and oils to clog the aphids, breathing holes and kill them. After a few hours, wash up the oil and soap with a garden hose. Repeat the application as necessary. It is very important to cover the entire plant thoroughly. Aphids have several natural enemies such as lady beetles, hoverflies, lacewings and parasitic wasps. When present in adequate numbers, natural enemies can suppress aphid populations. Cutworms are an occasional problem in all agricultural crops. Early detection is very important. symptoms often show up as late spots in alfalfa fields. In row crops, young seedlings will be served at ground level. If populations are high enough, about 1 square feet, controls are warranted. Bites can be applied, but often bite acceptance is a major problem. It is important to know which cutworm or armyworm you are dealing with, since many are nocturnal. And for these species, you must spray in the late afternoon and evening to get adequate control. Tillage and flood irrigation can reduce cutworm population. Large grasshopper populations generally developed on non-cultivated land and on land that has been left fallow or abandoned. These grasshopper populations are banded, then move to agricultural lands and feed on crops. Control must be aimed at the entire band of grasshoppers. Treating only a portion of the band will often result in a rapid reinfestation of the treated area. Treatment must also occur before grasshoppers being laying eggs. If properly treated, grasshoppers can be controlled in an area for up to 5 years. Control measures include a number of chemical controls. Remember to make sure the crops or site is specified on the product's label. Nosema locustae is a disease of grasshoppers. The biological control can be used effectively against grasshoppers if the proper conditions exist. Success is most dependent on the grasshopper species present, the life stage of grasshopper, and the habitat conditions. Coming to the thrips. Thrips and western flower thrips are two of the most damaging pests in the Pacific Northwest. Other species of thrips also thrive here. Immature and huddled thrips are tiny, slender, and vary in color. They live mainly in flowers and can be seen walking and feeding on leaves and other plant parts. Adults are very active and, when disturbed, move quickly and disappear. Their mouth parts can be either chewing or piercing, sucking types. Damage caused by large numbers of feeding thrips appears silvery in color and plants can die. Feeding on young fruit may result in scarring and russeting. Thrips are most damaging in the early stages of a crop. Plants might have difficulty recovering. Some species can transmit viruses. For example, western flower thrips, tobacco thrips, transmit tomato spotted wilt virus, that is TSWV. Sanitation is important because thrip populations tend to build up on weeds. Cultivate nearby weedy area before plants emerge. Later cultivation will increase the potential of a thrips problem. Overhead irrigation and rainfall provide some suppression of thrip population, but treatments often are still necessary. If chemical application is necessary, thorough coverage is essential, as most thrips feed in protected areas of the plant. Several beneficial insects feed on thrips and contribute to their control. The most notable is the minute parasitic bug. If using ideological control, select insecticides that minimize impacts on beneficials. Pest description and biology. Adults are tiny, moth-like insects that inhabit at undersurfaces of leaves and cause damage by penetrating tissue and removing plant sap with piercing, sucking mouth parts. In general, white flies go through an egg stage, 4 nymphal stages, and adult form. Only the first nymphal stage, crawlers, is mobile. Nymphs are flat, elliptical in shape and clear or creamy yellowish in color. Both nymphs and adults feed on leaves and other plants' parts. Excess sugar excrement causes accumulation of honeydew and subsequent growth of sooty mold. Some species transmit diseases such as tomato mottle virus (TOMOV) or tomato yellow leaf curl virus (TYLCV). Direct crop damage occurs when white flies feed in plant phloem, remove plant sap and reduce plant vigor. With high population, plants may die. White flies are particularly problematic on tomatoes, squashes, cucumbers, beans and other crops in both field and greenhouse production. Chemical control of white flies is expensive and difficult. Take into account factor such as although coverage, most white flies are located on the underside of the leaves, risk of secondary pest outbreak, risk of white flies developing insecticide resistance and regulatory restrictions on use of insecticides. Many natural enemies such as parasitic wasps can provide effective biological control, especially under greenhouse situations. The brown plant hopper (BPH), Nilaparvata lugens, Homoptera delphicidae, feeds on rice plants (Varisa sativa). BPH are among the most important pests of rice, and rice is the major staple crop for about half the world's population. They damage rice directly through feeding and also by transmitting two viruses, rice rage stunt virus and rice grassy stunt virus. Up to 60% of yield loss is common in susceptible rice cultivars attacked by BPH. The brown plant hopper (BPH) infests the rice crop at all stages of plant growth. As a result of feeding by both nymphs and adults, the base of the tillers plants turn yellow and dry up rapidly. At early infestation, round yellow patches appear, which soon turn brownish due to the drying up of the plants. This condition is called hopper burn. The hatchability and survival rate are the highest around 25 degrees Celsius. Eggs are very sensitive to desiccation and soon shrivel when the host plant starts wilting. The population growth of brown plant hopper is maximum at a temperature range of 28 to 30 degrees Celsius. Rice varieties with resistance to BPH, example IR64, are important for preventing outbreaks. However, in areas with low insecticide use, high levels of BPH resistance are not usually necessary. Chemical mutagenesis can significantly increase or decrease BPH resistance levels of rice. Some chemical insecticides, example imidacloprid, can affect the gene expression of rice and thereby increase susceptibility to BPH. In an attempt to make BPH control, more species-specific researchers are trying to develop methods of turning off specific BPH genes for digestion, defense, and xenobiotic metabolism. Many novel genes for these functions have been detected in tissue from BPH intensities. The coffee borer beetle, Hypothymus hempi, is a small beetle native Africa. It is also the most harmful pest of coffee crops across the world where coffee is cultivated. The larvae is white with a brown head and a length of 0.7 to 2.2 millimeter and a width of 0.2 to 0.6 millimeter. They have strong mandibles and their larval phase lasts 10 to 26 days. The pupae are yellowish with a length of 0.5 to 1.9 millimeter. The adults are small black beetles. Females are 1.4 to 1.8 millimeter long. The males are smaller, 1.2 to 1.6 millimeter long. Female beetles can fly short distances. Males have no wings. Females have 4 to 6 teeth in the frontal margin of the pronotum. H. hempi is confused sometimes with the false borer H. abascurus or H. seriatus, the Xylandrus scleratidae, but these species do not enter the coffee bean endosperm. The presence of the insect affects the economy over 20 million families that will depend on the coffee harvest. It has caused a marked reduction in the prices of coffee, reducing the scale price to growers. The beetle can destroy the entire harvest of an area. The main measures against the pest are preventivity. The application of efficient control programs is difficult since the coffee plant is perennial. With several flowering periods, the growth in the areas are very unpredictable weather. Insecticides are useful only before the female beetles presents berry. There are reports of resistance to endosulfone. During the time when beetles offspring emerge from each commercially ruined berry to disperse, they are vulnerable to predation. The yellow warbler, rufous capped warbler and other insectivorous birds have been shown to reduce by 50% the number of coffee berry borer beetles in Costa Rica coffee plantations. The diamondback moth, Plutella xylitola, sometimes called cabbage moth, is a European moth believed to originate in the Mediterranean region that has since spread worldwide. The moth has a short life cycle, 14 days at 25 degrees Celsius. It is highly fecund and capable of migrating long distances. It is one of the most important pests of cruciferous crops in the world and will usually only feed on plants that produce glucosinolates. However, not all of these plants are equally useful as hosts to the moth. There has been some discussions of using winter scissors as a buffer plant around agricultural fields, as the diamondback moth are highly attracted to the plant and their eggs fail to survive with oviposited on it. The seed corn maggot adults is a slender light gravy fly about 3 to 8 inch long. Four stages occur: egg, larvae, pupae and adults. Eggs are white with raised ridges. Seed corn maggot is abundant primarily in the spring during or following a wet cycle. It is most common in fields with high amounts of organic matter or recently incorporated vegetation. Seed corn maggots burrow into seeds, preventing germination or reducing vigor. Slow emergence and poor stand establishment are signs of the seed corn maggot activity. In some crops, such as onions, the larvae will tunnel up and seedling stem, causing plant death. Cool soil temperatures and excessive moisture that cause slow seed germination and emergence of seedling can increase susceptibility to seed corn maggot infestation. Dry beans, lima beans, snap beans, broccoli, Brussels, cabbage, cauliflower, cucumber, onions, green peas, pumpkins and squash. Recommendations to reduce seed corn maggot infestation. Reduce attractiveness to egg laying adults by incorporating green plant and organic matter. We will before planting. Delay planting until temperature and moisture are appropriate. Plant under ideal soil and weather conditions to assure rapid seed germination and emergence. Insecticidal seed treatments are the most commonly used control methods. Entomophagous fungi are important natural control agents of adults in some areas. Some parasitic nematodes also can be effective. Mites are not insects but arachnids. They have 8 legs. Mites often appear under dry conditions prior to the first irrigation. Often the first irrigation will reduce their populations by knocking them off the plants and interrupting their life cycle. Mites cause damage by sucking plant juices. Damage first appears as stippling, small yellow areas on leaves. Severe damage causes leaves to dry and then drop from the plant. The mites are found on the undersides of the leaves and the infestation usually starts on the lower older leaves and moves upwards. Minimizing plant stress through improved cultural practices such as proper irrigation and fertilization can aid plants in withstanding an infestation. Some microorganisms including bacteria, fungi, viruses cause diseases in plants. Microorganisms that cause diseases in plants are also known as plant pathogens. Xanthomonas campestris cause bacterial leaf spots in chili. Phytophthora infestans is a plant parasitic fungus causing the late blight disease in potato. Many viruses cause disease symptoms such as mosaic, yellowing, leaf curls, puckering, brunchy tops, etc. Plant parasitic nematodes are usually too small to be seen without a hand lens or a dissection microscope. Because of their tiny size, they remain unstudied for a very long time. Several crop diseases are caused by nematodes, root and seed galls, stubby roots, yellowing, etc. are few examples. Vertebrate pests. Vertebrate pests include animals such as wild pig, monkeys, bear, elephant, deer, the rodents and birds. Mollusks. These includes slugs and snails. Weeds are unwanted plants in the field that compete with the crop plants for water, nutrient and light. Many parasitic plants depend on the host tree for their growth and reproduction. Loranthus is an example of a parasitic plant in Bhutan. It is found in citrus, peach and pear trees. Classification based on occur, regular pests, a pest that occurs every crop season and causes yield loss, sporadic pests, a pest that irregular but occasionally causes problems. It is a pest that occurs here and there in an irregular and random pattern. Potential pest, a pest that could become highly noxious if allowed to establish. Major pests, many insects feed on our crops, but all are not pests to be designated as pest an insect must be responsible for an economic yield loss of at least 5%. Insects are categorized into major and minor pests based on the percentage of economic yield loss they cause. Major pests are those that cause damage over 10%. Minor pests, these are that cause damage between 5% to the 10%. Damages below 5% are tolerable and often negligible.